So let me introduce myself. Myself, Omkar Bharnuke, leading the Nepal as well as the North India as a territory as a solution architect and a consultant for Juniper Juniper Solutions and product portfolio completely. So today, I'll talk about what are the correct market trends, then the cloud and its adoption, then the journey towards the cloud, how you can build your clouds, then our solutions and the products regarding this, and then the advanced security solutions for Juniper. So if you talk about the current market trends and what are the current requirements, so social media and the big data, you know that bring your own device, BYOD services, and then again your Facebook. Everyone has his own smartphone in hand, so, and then your applications like Facebook, then your Twitter, LinkedIn, all those applications. There is a massive data flow from one location to the another location. So if you talk about the data centers, machine to machine communication is very high. Then your east-west traffic, rather than the north-west traffic, north-south traffic, the east-west traffic is going increasing massively. And for that, the major requirement is that your topology, what is your data center network topology is there, that should be more flatter rather than the hierarchical architecture what we have recently and what we are running right now. The next is that the virtualization, so everyone is looking out into the installing the services on any bare metal hardware, how I can spin the VM on any bare metal hardware, host my services on that and quickly deliver the services to the customers. The next is the cloud. Again, the SaaS model is growing massively. Everyone is looking out the services from the cloud, that is, that can be the Microsoft Office 365, your Salesforce and all those services, then your Google as a cloud. So the customers, and even there is a massive demand for the cloud-based services. So let's talk about where we are and where we want to go. So what is the path to the success? If today we have here that any service we need, we are raising the request to your admin that I need this particular service at this time. So whenever you are raising the request, the admin will take its own time. It will rack the switches, push the configuration in the switches, then the security team will push the security policies, and then after a few days or maybe the week's time, your service gets delivered. So, and you need to be here that everyone wants to be, whatever the my service is there, that needs to be delivered within the one click. So, but how do you want to make sure that? How do you go over there? Is the SDN and the orchestration, is the live solution? Then what about the security? If you are having the one click portal with you, what is going inside? Do you have any visibility of that? What is your security prospect, how you can secure your data, and then the support is the main important aspect whenever you are delivering any service to your customers. How you can going to support that? So let's talk about the cloud. So it is not just one day process that right now you are running your data centers in traditional way and suddenly you can move into the cloud as a cloud-based data centers. It is a journey, it is a step-by-step process. So let's say that your current data center is the legacy IT data centers and you want to move towards the cloud-based data centers, that may be the public cloud or hybrid cloud data centers. So what are the basic blocks that are required? That is a stage-based approach towards the cloud, that is modernization of your network topology, then your networks should be flatter so that we can easily scale, we can easily get the high performance so that lower latency is the major requirement for your data centers right now. Again, the centralization and orchestration of your and automation, how you can manage it very well from the central position, how you can orchestrate that, how you can deliver your service with the central management point, that is single management point. This is the key, and then the virtualization, where you want to spin your VMs with VMware or VXLAN environment, and then the XSI environment, and you can have your security on top of that. So any L2 environment like your data center, even the networking, that have just the visibility till L2 or L3. So what about the layer 4 to layer 7 visibility? So for that, you even need the security in the data center, because that is crucial data what the customer is hosting on the data centers, and that needs to be secure. So let's talk about the journey.